Have you ever heard of Viagra or Cialis? They're two of the most common pills men talk about when it comes to erectile dysfunction. But here's the real question. Do you actually know the difference between them? One might last just a few hours, the other could keep working through the entire weekend. And depending on your body, lifestyle, and health, one may fit you much better than the other. In this video, we're going to break it down in simple, clear language. No confusing medical talk. Just what you really need to know about Sildenafil, that's Viagra, and Tadalafil, that's Cialis. I'm Dr. Emily Carter, and my goal is to help you understand your options so you can feel more confident, safe, and informed. So let's get started. Before we compare Viagra and Cialis, you need to understand how an erection actually happens. It all starts with arousal. You see something, you feel something, you hear something, your brain gets the signal. That signal tells your body to release nitric oxide. Think of nitric oxide as the spark that turns the key in your engine. Once that spark is there, your body produces a messenger called cGMP. This messenger relaxes the smooth muscles in the penis, which lets blood flow in. At the same time, the veins that normally drain blood get blocked, so the blood stays there. That's how the penis becomes firm. Now, how does an erection end? There are three main ways. The arousal fades. That messenger, cGMP, naturally breaks down. After ejaculation, the nervous system tells the muscles to tighten again, pushing blood out. Here's the key point. Both Viagra and Cialis work by stopping the breakdown of cGMP. They block an enzyme called PDE5, so cGMP stays longer and you get a stronger, longer-lasting erection. Now, before we talk about the differences between Viagra and Cialis, you need to know about the possible side effects. Most men do just fine on these medications, but some common issues can show up. Headaches, flushing, a warm red face, nasal congestion, stuffy nose, heartburn or indigestion. And in a small number of men, there can be changes in vision. Things might look a bit blue or blurry. There are also important warnings. If you are taking nitrate medications for heart problems, like nitroglycerin for chest pain, you cannot use Viagra or Cialis. The combination can make your blood pressure drop dangerously low. If you have kidney or liver disease, your doctor may need to adjust the dose. Be very careful with herbal or online products that claim to boost erections. Some secretly contain Viagra or Cialis without proper labeling, and that can be unsafe. Finally, there are a couple of rare but serious side effects. Priapism, an erection that lasts longer than 4 hours. It sounds like a joke, but it's actually an emergency because it can damage the tissue. Sudden hearing loss, extremely rare, but it has been reported. The key takeaway? These medications are generally safe and effective when prescribed by a doctor and taken the right way. Let's start with Viagra, also known by its generic name, Sildenafil. This was the first pill ever approved for erectile dysfunction back in the late 1990s. Interestingly, Viagra wasn't even made for erections at first. It was tested as a medicine for high blood pressure, but during the trials, men started reporting something unexpected. Their erections got stronger and firmer. That side effect became the main effect, and Viagra was born. Here's how Viagra works in real life. You need to take it about 30 to 60 minutes before sex. It works best on an empty stomach. If you eat a heavy, fatty meal first, the pill may not work as well. It lasts for about 4 hours in your body. It's only available as an on-demand medication. That means you take it when you need it, not every day. The usual doses range from 25 milligrams up to 100 milligrams, depending on your doctor's advice. Now, what about side effects that are unique to Viagra? Some men notice a blue-green tint in their vision. If that happens, you should stop and talk to your doctor. Rarely, Viagra can cause nosebleeds, although this is not very common. So Viagra is a good option if you want something short-acting, effective, and generally affordable. But remember, it's a plan-ahead pill. You can't just take it anytime and expect it to last the whole weekend. Now let's talk about Cialis, also known as Tadalafil. This pill came onto the market a few years after Viagra in the early 2000s, and it quickly earned the nickname the weekend pill. Why that name? Because Cialis lasts much longer in the body, up to 36 hours. That doesn't mean you'll have a constant erection for a day and a half. It simply means the medication stays active, so you have a much larger window for intimacy without having to watch the clock. Here's how Cialis works in practice. Like Viagra, you take it about 30 minutes before sex. But unlike Viagra, it doesn't matter if you've eaten a big meal. It still works. It comes in two styles. On-demand doses, 5 milligrams to 20 milligrams, can you take when needed. Low-dose daily pills, 2.5 milligrams to 5 milligrams, that you take every day, so you're always ready. For many couples, the daily option feels more natural. It takes away the planning and allows intimacy to be more spontaneous. There's also a bonus with Cialis. It's FDA approved to treat BPH, benign prostatic hyperplasia, or in simple words, an enlarged prostate. Men with BPH often struggle with symptoms like needing to urinate often, especially at night, feeling like the bladder doesn't fully empty. Urgency, that gotta go now feeling. Cialis can help with those symptoms and with erections, so it's a two-in-one solution for many men. What about side effects? Instead of vision changes like Viagra, Cialis is more likely to cause muscle or back aches. These are usually mild and fade on their own. So if you want a pill that offers spontaneity, lasts longer, and may help with urinary issues, Cialis is often the better fit. So now the big question, which pill is better, Viagra or Cialis? Here's the honest truth. Both are very effective, with success rates around 60 to 80%. That means most men will see improvement with either pill. But there have been many studies comparing the two, and the results tell an interesting story. One large meta-analysis looked at over 5,000 men across 16 studies. Here's what they found. In terms of pure erection strength, both drugs worked about the same. But when researchers asked about satisfaction, confidence, and relationships, men taking Cialis often scored higher. Their partners also tended to prefer Cialis because it allowed for more spontaneity. No rushing, no strict timing, just more freedom. Now, let's look at side effects. With Viagra, vision changes are more common. Some men notice a blue-green tint in their sight. With Cialis, muscle or back aches are more likely. These usually go away, but they can be bothersome for some. So how do you decide? If you want a pill that works reliably, quickly, and you don't mind planning ahead, Viagra is a solid choice. If you want flexibility, a longer window, and maybe even help with urinary problems, Cialis often comes out on top. And here's a pro tip. If one doesn't work well for you, it doesn't mean you're out of options. Many men try both at different times. Sometimes just switching makes all the difference. Even though Viagra and Cialis are the most common choices, they're not the only options for treating erectile dysfunction. For men who don't respond well to pills, doctors may recommend intraurethral suppositories, tiny pellets placed inside the urethra to stimulate an erection. Intracavernosal injections, small injections directly into the penis. It sounds scary, but they are highly effective for men who don't respond to oral medication. Vacuum erection devices, pumps that create suction, drawing blood into the penis and keeping it there with a ring. Penile implants, a surgical option that provides a permanent, reliable solution for severe cases. These alternatives show that erectile dysfunction is a treatable condition. There is always another path forward if one option doesn't work. So here's the takeaway. Viagra and Cialis are both safe, effective, and life-changing for many men. Viagra is short-acting and cost-friendly. Cialis offers a longer window, daily options, and even helps with urinary problems. If one doesn't work, switching might be the answer. The key is simple. Talk to your doctor and choose the option that fits your life best. And if this video helped you understand the differences more clearly, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe for more clear health guidance, and share this video with a friend who might need it. Your health, your confidence, and your relationships are worth it. Take care of yourself, and I'll see you in the next video.